so amazing and keeps us stargazing. What do we think we might see? Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and they called the young sailors. The voice might be one and the same. I've heard it too many times to ignore it. It's something that I'm supposed to be. Someday we'll find it. The lovers, the dreamers, and me. Da 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 da.
From the City of Orlando, whereas lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and questioning people throughout many cities in the United States and other countries participate in annual parades, festivals, and events collectively called Gay Pride, and whereas Come Out with Pride 2020 is not the usual weekend full of fabulous events hosted at multiple locations, but instead the community is rising to the occasion of adapting and celebrating in a different but still fabulous way, in a celebration of pride that includes a vehicle procession, virtual events for all to enjoy from the safety of their homes. And whereas Gay Pride is a symbol of solidarity and an opportunity to express the vivid personalities which reflect the diverse gay community all across the City of Orlando and this great country and across the world. And whereas the City of Orlando does hereby recognize and salute that diversity and welcome and embrace the inclusion of all members of the LGBTQ community as part of what makes Orlando a world-class community, and further deems Come Out with Pride 2020 as a world-class event that celebrates the diversity of all. Now, therefore, we, Buddy Dyer, Mayor of the of Orlando, and Patty Sheehan, Commissioner of District 4, do hereby proclaim Saturday, October 10th, 2020 as Come Out with Pride Day in the City of Orlando.
No, it's like this, right?
Wait, what is it?
It's Pride in the House. Pride in the House.
Pride in the House.
Pride, come Out with Pride presents Pride in the House.
Come Out with Pride presents Pride in the House.
Right,
like,
ready?
In the House?
In the House.
Okay, in,
right, ready?
In the House.
One, two, three. Come Out with Pride presents Pride in the House. House. No, you were supposed to like in the house.
Okay.
Try it again, ready? Right. One, two, three. Come out with pride presents pride in the house.
Is that it?
That was it. You nailed it.
You're so good. I feel like I'm in my house.
Hi, everybody. You guys are in your house, and I want to take a moment to introduce one of your hosts for tonight. This is the incredible Blue Star.
Oh, it's great to be here. And of course, the other host, Rob Ward, in the house.
Hi, everybody. Pride is in the house.
I'm proud in my house.
I'm proud everywhere I go, but especially in the house.
I feel like I'm in my house, and I'm really proud to be here.
Now, you know where we are? We are in front of whatever ends up on this screen behind us, because currently we're actually on a green screen.
We are.
Which means I'm wearing a rainbow, so this is probably invisible right here. So whatever's behind us, you probably also see
on
my
chest. It's going to be great when like Lake Eola is like on your chest.
It's always been a dream. So we want to welcome you to Come Out With Pride presents Pride in the House.
Yeah, because we can't be here in person because it's 2020 and there's clearly been some things going on.
Absolutely, but we can't, especially this year of all years, Pride can't go away. We gotta have it. So today we're bringing the Pride to you.
In your house!
In your house. It is Pride in the House. We have so much fun coming up. Like I said, Come Out With Pride was not gonna leave you without Pride this year.
No, because we're proud no matter what.
Absolutely. And so we've got incredible entertainers. This year,
we
said we're gonna bring this to you guys. So we're gonna make it a celebration
in
of
your
our
house.
City. In your house.
In your house.
Your house.
In your house.
Your house. And you should really clean up that area behind you on your computer. That looks a mess. You know who I'm talking
to. Try a different camera angle. Maybe get some light.
Yeah, that would help.
I feel like that's all we've done this year.
That's what we've been doing.
Trying to perfect our Zoom. It's just been a crazy year.
I'll bet you Zoom like nobody else can Zoom.
I am Zooming. I can't say what that because normally I would say those things, but now I'm in your house.
What about, all I want to do is I'm a Zoom, Zoom, Zoom.
And a boom, boom.
There we go.
And then I shank my rump.
And you
Can you say that on Friday?
No, this is PG. So we've got incredible entertainers coming to you from some of your favorite locations throughout Orlando, some of your favorite performers.
Gay locations.
Yes, lots of the G and the LGBTQ locations.
Yeah.
We've got Southern Nights represented, Stonewall, Savoy, Parliament House.
And the house.
And the house,
yeah,
which you'll learn more about later in this show. And you know who else is coming to your house?
Who?
She's not local, but she wanted to be here with you guys too. Coming up tonight, Robin S. performing her hit, Show Me Love.
She's gonna show us some love.
I hope she does. And some local hometown love. We have Roxxxy Andrews headlining tonight.
Triple X.
Yes, Roxxxy with three X's.
That's it.
And of course, your baby girl headlining tonight.
Detox in the house.
I can't wait for us to get to those things. But you know what?
What?
I think it's time for us to kick off some party. Do you want to do it?
Yeah, let's do it. And I think the person that we have coming up next is the perfect way to start out Pride in the House today. She is my sister. I love her so much. She is coming to you, not live, but live. But at one point in time, it was live.
She was live. She did perform. We did film it.
Yeah.
And so now it's live in your home for the first time.
Because it's Pride in the House.
Yeah.
So if you would, please welcome to our virtual stage here with Come Out With Pride in your house, Maya Andrews.
Tengo, 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 t las palabras que faltan a la verdad. Llevo cantos en el alma de amor a la libertad. Y si entrego mis pasiones, no hay barreras para amar. Cuando son dos corazones que se quieren de verdad. Y me digo,
greetings. I'm Orange County Mayor Jerry Demings. It is my pleasure to congratulate Come Out With Pride on your 16th anniversary. I applaud your dedication and commitment to fostering relationships and showcasing our diverse population. As the mayor of Orange County, it is my vision to create a community culture of innovation, collaboration, and inclusion, where all people are respected for who they are and no one is left behind. While we begin to recover from the effects of the coronavirus, I am reminded of what can be accomplished when we all work together during times of hardship. This is evident by the actions of many talented organizers, volunteers, and entertainers who have worked diligently to host Come Out With Pride in a new, innovative, and virtual way. Thank you for continuing the tradition of the most colorful event in Central Florida. On the eve of National Coming Out Day, I want to encourage each and every person watching to continue living as your true, authentic self. Happy Pride, Orange County.
See, I love that so much. Maya, always turning it out for you at Southern Nights. My sister, thank you so much for participating in Come Out With Pride.
Mm-hmm.
We're filming
hey.
Right now.
That was Jeff Prostyko, board president of Come Out With Pride. He's been watching this live, and he said we were a little too much on that first segment. So
but we're
maybe,
in the house.
Well, it was we were like Pride out on the streets, which happened earlier today.
But I'm proud.
We need to take it down a notch and be a little more formal. So, can we do that?
Okay.
Hello, welcome to Pride in the House.
Is that it?
That's it. That's
okay.
Let's keep moving.
Okay, let's do it. This next segment I'm really excited for because
so much fun.
They are pillars on Church Street and always celebrating brunch better than almost anyone.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like you get down if you love Broadway. You know, you like
the Broadway
show
brunch is where it's at.
It really is. It's a lot of show tunes.
Yeah. Also, we're going to take you over to Hamburger Mary's for Broadway brunch in a moment. But what I love, and I have to shout out, is the day that we filmed this, it was pouring down rain. And they said, you know what? We're gonna take advantage of it, and we're going to make it part of the show. So I can't wait till you guys see how they did that.
Oh, this is going to be amazing. I can't wait. So here it is, Broadway brunch at Hamburger Mary's Orlando.
Rented my tux, bought flowers, $12, and on my 23rd try, I finally tied my tie. I got this feeling that time's no longer holding me down.
$50 told you I had a favorite part from the movie? Well, stand up and take a look out in the street if you can to see what's happening out there. Come in after you can.
Good evening, I'm Orlando Mayor Buddy Dyer, and I want to welcome you to the virtual Come Out With Pride celebration. Each year, Come Out With Pride fills our downtown streets with love, inclusion, and support for all LGBTQ plus people. COVID-19 has changed the way we come together to celebrate one another, but has not changed our commitment to true inclusion in the City Beautiful. 2020 has been a challenging year. COVID-19 has impacted every single person in our community. We've also witnessed an awakening against racial inequity, and in response, we've made policy changes in our police department and investments in youth programming, job readiness, and affordable housing to provide more opportunities to support residents who felt the impacts of centuries of systematic racism in our country. I'm proud to stand here as an ally to the LGBTQ plus community. I've always believed in creating a city where all residents have equal access to opportunities and protections against discrimination. I'm proud to share that we've received a perfect score on the Human Rights Campaign Municipal Equality Index for the past 6 years. And this year we stood with our transgender community to remind local homeless shelters of their obligation to protect transgender residents against discrimination in their facilities. Despite all the obstacles and challenge we've faced this year, we are a city that comes together like no other in a time of crisis. We will continue living up to the reputation as a city that celebrates and embraces our differences. We are committed to the work that it will take to recover, heal, and find our path forward together. Thank you to the Come Out With Pride board and volunteers for all of your hard work. And remember, we can't let our guard down yet. So please stay safe, follow CDC guidelines, and wear a face covering when necessary. Have a great evening.
What a feeling.
What a feeling.
I have got a feeling.
I brought a bucket of water to pour on your head.
I can't wait. I've never done
that. No, I'm not
going to
do that. Look at your beautiful hair.
It looks gay today.
That's what we're doing.
It's my lesbian cut.
You were like the epitome of lesbian cut. That's your thing. That's what you do.
I guess so.
You were the L of the LGBT.
I mean, like, can we say lesbian? Am I lesbian?
Why can't we say lesbian?
I don't know. There's so many letters and things. And, you know, it's been a year of change. And I'm just, you know, I have to say that it's been really awesome to watch Orlando come together and rise up together.
For sure.
To fight for what we believe in. I mean, we've been doing that with pride over the years. But this year with Black Lives Matter, we really saw an unprecedented turnout of Orlando people coming together and fighting for what they believe is right, right?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen our communities, we've been through it before in Orlando, you know? Orlando's a city of survivors, and so we've had to come together as a community before, but this year you've really seen people coming together, marching in the streets, getting the word out, supporting one another, and it's never been more important than it is in 2020.
I agree. And there's, you know, one person that's really been at the forefront of this movement. I'll let you introduce.
It's Darcell Stevens. If you don't know Darcell Stevens, then you don't know Orlando. Darcell has been out in the forefront, as always, really pushing her messages of equality, love, and support. So we had to take a moment to head over to Parliament House, hear from Darcell, and see an amazing performance from her.
Let's go there now.
Here's Darcell Stevens.
Taking it to your house.
Hey guys, this is Darcell Stevens, and I'm here at the world famous Parliament House. And I just want to wish everybody a happy Pride. And folks ask me, why is Pride so important? And I want to let you know that Pride is more important now than it has ever been, especially in this COVID-19 era. We need to feel a sense of family. We need to feel that sense of hope. And nothing works better than being around your brothers and sisters who are same-sex gender loving. And Pride kind of brings that out. Now, this year's Pride is very different, but after we've been shut down and cooped up in our homes for a couple of months, anything we're looking forward to. And so this year's Pride is going to be a caravan of cars, and I'm looking forward to just putting on a makeup and not the rest of my body and waving at the straight folks and letting them know that I got pride. And pride has just been something very special to me the many years I've been here in Orlando. I've been to prides where the Ku Klux Klans were out protesting against our right to assemble. And I've been to prides where the Christian right has been out, and I've been to the prides where we were just as gay as we wanted to be. But pride has always been something significant for a person who comes from a small town to be a part of something so big and so grand, something bigger than myself, to just basically say I'm here and I'm validated. That is so important. And for the young kids, today it's a really different time. When I was young, that was 3 weeks ago, but it's been, the young kids don't really, they really take a lot of what we do for granted, but there was a time when Pride was the only time we really came out. We snuck into bars and we, you know, fraternized with one another and danced with one another, but in daylight, we were totally somebody different. We hid, we didn't come out. And then these Pride parades came out, and that was the time that we had to make a conscious choice to be out, because we didn't know whether our jobs were going to see us, whether our parents were going to see us, our loved ones, our friends, but we had to affirm ourselves, and Pride gave us that opportunity to be who we are authentically. And I thank Pride for that, because I grew up in Dunellen, Florida. Don't even try to Google it, it's a small town. And Gainesville, Florida, and that wasn't the case. And but when I got to Orlando, there was something big, something grand that gave me an opportunity to be myself and to come out and tell the world that I'm gay and I'm proud. And I'm very, very, very happy to continue that legacy of being a part of Come Out With Pride here in Orlando.
Time to help you welcome to the stage your host, Ms. Darcell Stevens. Welcome to Mr. Down Love.
Yes, I'm in my Wonder Woman dress. I feel like a woman. I feel like a Wonder Woman. Hello, everybody. How you doing? Good, good, good. Well, it's another day in the neighborhood, and I do want to thank all of you all for continuing to wear your mask and practice your social distancing. Well, welcome to the Parliament House. Where are you from? Central Florida. Your English is so good. Yeah. Well, welcome to Orlando. Welcome to Orlando. But you enjoy yourself, and welcome to the Parliament House. You know, all of this is really not me. You know that? All of this is not me. All of this is not me. All of that back there, down there is me. But all of this is not me. Everything is just
fake. Yes, it is. But it's put together beautifully. Don't you like this Wonder Woman dress that I have on? You know, I searched hard and long for this dress, and I finally stopped at one of the fabulous boutiques somewhere close by the Millennium Mall called Walmart. And it just wasn't anywhere. It was in the lingerie department as a sleeping garment. And I said, if it's good enough to be slept in, it's good enough to wear in a gay bar, okay? So, everyone, you know what we need to do. We're not children. We're adults, and we know this game by now. Just make sure that you adhere to those rules. Keep yourself safe. Remember, your mask protects the other person, not you, okay? So if you don't have a mask on, then you're just spewing everything. Make sure you stay with your group. Enjoy the Parliament House. Drink up. Do whatever you need to do. Let's have ourselves a good time. Are you ready for the show? Say hell yeah! Hell yeah! Come on, y'all. Y'all gonna say hell yeah!
Miss Darcell Stevens.
Ashamed of all my scars. Run away. Inclusive, affirmative, justice-seeking. Join us.
We are standing on the side of love.
Darcell bringing the feels, right?
Darcell, like tales from the dressing room, just like every Sunday when I wake up and I look at my Instagram and Facebook, and there she is, tales from the dressing room.
Yeah, if you don't follow Darcell Stevens on Facebook, make sure you do that, because you'll get all of the dressing room tales, which are great. And that performance was lovely, and you know, we always love the world famous Parliament House Resort, but we were so excited this year for Pride in the House to take it all over Orlando. And one place that we were surprised was so excited to have us there was Icon Park, where they have the wheel, the Orlando wheel.
That's iconic.
Right.
Yeah.
And they lit the whole place up. It's beautiful. And we had some of your dancers there.
Yeah, Jack Krieger and Katrina Sorcelli. Of course, Variety's favorites that you might know and love from over the years. Dancing their little booties off because they are amazing. And I couldn't actually picture any other people dancing in front of this huge icon.
Right.
At Icon Park. So it is Varieties with Katrina Sorcelli and Jack Krieger at the Orlando Wheel.
World, I want to leave you better. I want my life to matter. alive. I am afraid I have no purpose here. I watch the news on TV, abandon myself daily. I am afraid to let you see the real me. When it falls, when it falls, pardon me. The rain it falls, when it falls. Sowing the seeds of love and hope, love and love. We don't have to stay stuck in the weeds.
On behalf of the Gay Straight Alliance at Nissan, or GSON, we just wanted to say, Happy Pride.
Happy Pride!
Happy Pride!
This year, we will all celebrate a little bit differently, and that's okay.
Because at Nissan, our pride isn't just 1 month out of the year.
Our pride lasts all year long,
of Happy Pride from your friends and family at Nissan.
We rise up together against division and the forces of hate in this country. An attack on one of us is an attack on all of us. We show up. We speak up. And when you vote, we win. Now, we need you to show up for all of us. We vote for equality. Vote early, vote today.
CVS Health is proud to support Come Out With Pride. We share a clear purpose, helping people on their path to better health. And together, we can help to end this HIV epidemic. Talk to us about testing, prevention, and treatment. Connect with an HIV patient advocate by calling 786-220-8865. Happy Pride from CVS Health.
Hey,
look
at
us.
1, 2, 3.
Ah!
Yay.
Aww.
Yeah, I'm going to post that.
Yeah, I'm
going to
post it right now. Hashtag.
You know what? If you guys also post along with us, hashtag Pride in the House.
Yeah.
We want to see your lovely faces from Come Out With Pride. So make sure, post your pictures on social media and hashtag it Pride in the House.
Yeah, you can find us on Instagram at Come Out With Pride. Got it?
Got it.
Hashtag.
Hashtag Pride in the house.
That's it.
I love that.
I do too. Let's talk about something that you know and love with people that we love, that do good things that we all love, and we love people in Orlando, and this happened.
That was a lot of love. What do we love? What do you love?
I love Drag Race. I love
Drag Race.
But it's not RuPaul's Drag Race. This is actually something that's been going on a long time.
Yeah, that's right. We've got the Drag Race 5K. Some of you have already run it. Some of you have yet to do that, though, and you still have a couple days to sign up. So this year, obviously, like everything else, the Drag Race 5K has gone virtual. So you get to take a run, a 5K run, wherever you want. Take pictures, take video along the way. But also, while you're doing your run, we've got a podcast with some amazing drag queens giving commentary as you go through. It's super fun. I did it the other day, and I had a great time with it. The weather was great.
So. I think it's one of those years where we just have to get creative, and certainly they've done a great job doing so with that.
Absolutely. And we want to thank our partner Zebra Coalition, who helped to bring the Drag Race 5K. If you still want to do the Drag Race 5K too, check out our website, comeoutwithpride.com, and you can sign up right there. There's still time.
Do it. Yes. I don't know where you're running to, but have a good time.
You know where you could run on your 5K? You could run over to Savoy, Orlando.
Oh, I love Savoy. Ivanhoe Village. You can just like get your drink on. And of course, you can see this next entertainer there, who is also one of our grand marshals. It's Chantel Roche.
And at a party I don't want to be at, and I don't ever wear a suit and tie, wondering if I can sneak out the back, nobody's even looking me in my eye. Then you take my hand, finish my drink, say shall we dance, oh yeah. You know I love you, did I ever tell you, you make it better like that. Don't think we fit in at this party, everyone's got so much to say. Make it better like that. Don't think I fit in at this party. Everyone's got so much to say.
Are you an LGBT veteran in the Central Florida area? Then we here at the Orlando VA Healthcare System would like you to know that we have a wide array of services and supports available to you. We want you to know that we have your six and we will be there for you for all your healthcare needs. Thank you for your service.
Awesome. We have gone to so many different cool locations for Pride in the House, and there's so many more to come. But the next one that we got to visit, I was super excited about because it was a sneak peek at a place that I know we're going to be spending a lot of time in Orlando. You obviously are pretty close to this place.
I've been in there. I've kind of made that house my home.
Yes. So we got to take a little sneak peek at House Orlando. In case people don't know, tell them what House is.
It's House with an umlaut. H-A with an umlaut. O-S.
Umlaut.
Yes, umlaut. We're bringing it back.
That's also my drag name. I am umlaut back.
We're really excited to have you all there, and something that we've been working on over the past couple of months. And I know it's kind of crazy to open a restaurant with art and theater, but in the middle of a pandemic, that's okay. But I thought that it was something that could give Orlando some hope and something to look forward to. And of course, it's just a challenging time, but you know, no better time like the present to face your obstacles and face your fears and make that house with an umlaut your home. So,
and you helped create some great art with an umlaut. at this place.
I love creating art with umlauts.
It's my favorite.
It's my specialty. I didn't know until now.
Listen to our podcast, Art with Umlauts, coming soon on all streaming platforms.
So we're going to take you inside the house, which we aren't open yet, but we will be soon, so stay tuned for that. But until then, it's Zach Robinson performing in the house.
With an umlaut.
With an umlaut.
Some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Let's fly away. Get you up there, where the air is rarefied. Oh, you'll just fly, so starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near that you.
My advice to someone who feels like they don't look like everyone else around the table is to get to know people individually. The less we know about somebody, the more we tend to assume about someone.
Coming to work and having a diverse team that's willing to offer their input and be included in the conversation is very important to me. That will ensure that we are answering the demands of our marketplace and of our customers.
Orlando Health, Health Central Hospital,
and Orlando Health Horizon West Hospital
are proud to support Come Out With Pride and our inspiring diversity of our team members and our community.
Orlando Health Arnold Palmer Hospital is proud to support
Come Out With Pride
and the beautiful diversity
of our team members
and our community.
Orlando Health South Sentinel Hospital supports Come Out With Pride.
Orlando Health U of Health Cancer Center is proud of the diversity of our patients,
our team members,
and our community.
Orlando Health Winnie Palmer Hospital for Women and Babies is honored to support Come Out With Pride. We value the incredible diversity of our team members and our community.
That was a beautiful trip to the house.
Yeah, wasn't it?
With an umlaut.
We're really going to mess people up with that. We'll be like, meet you at the house, and then I'm going to go home and send people there.
We actually, I've already had that when we were rehearsing. You were like, let's meet at the house. And I thought it was your house, but it was
the other house. Yeah.
With an umlaut. Your home doesn't have an umlaut.
My home does not have an umlaut.
But it still can. So
I can do whatever.
Set your goals high.
Create what you want.
Exactly. And you know what I want is I want to make sure that we have entertainment that everybody can enjoy. And I hope you guys have been enjoying all the entertainment we've had so far. Also, earlier in the day, hopefully you got to catch some of our family-friendly entertainment from Kids Fringe.
Kids Fringe!
Yes, the virtual Rainbow Ranch. So fun. And we love to be able to provide entertainment that the entire family can enjoy.
Of course.
And especially things for our LGBTQ youth that are out there.
Yeah.
And if you are an LGBTQ youth or the parent of one, there is an event we want to make sure you know about coming up on October 24th. It is the Orlando Youth Empowerment Summit, known as Oh Yes.
Oh Yes!
So this will be the third in a series of virtual events, but there are still spots for people to come enjoy. We've also had a lot of fun celebrities pop into those summits so far. We had Raven from RuPaul's Drag Race.
Whoa!
Came in. My favorite was last month, though, Senator Elizabeth Warren popped in to say
what?
Hello. So the next one will be October 24th, and if you would like to find out more about that, you can go to orlyes.org and sign up.
It's important for us to take care of our youth.
Absolutely.
Our future is important.
Our future is very important.
Very important.
And some future performers who are already stars, but they keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger, are coming up next.
I know, they were like little babies, and now they're like not babies, but they're not fully grown yet.
They're teenagers, but not actual teenagers.
I would say they're kind of more like college students.
Okay, so they're drag college students who don't go to college.
And they're older than college.
Let's just say they're names.
Yes, okay, perfect. Coming to you live, not live, from Stonewall Bar, which got a little facelift.
You know, yeah, we filmed in there, and they had a beautiful new upgrade in there. You'll see some of it on this film.
Well, it's Black Magics, Cara Cavalli Andrews, and Mr. and Ms. Adrian. Enjoy.
Bang bang cocking it, Queen Nikki dominant, prominent. It's me, Jesse and Ari. If they test me, they sorry. Riders up like a Harley, then pull off in this Ferrari. If he hanging, we banging. Phone ringing, he slanging. It ain't karaoke night, but get the mic, cause I'm singing. B to the A, to the N, to the G. B to the A, to the N, to the G. Hey.
See anybody come and go up to you? You need a bag, gotta burn your I'm Lori.
I'm Kathy.
We're with J. Myers Insurance Agency here in Orlando since 1974. We're a family-owned agency working on the fifth generation.
We'd like to take this opportunity to invite you to become part of our insurance family. Have a great time while you're celebrating Come Out with Pride 2020.
Call us about your insurance. Thanks.
Hey y'all, I'm Emily.
And I'm Kevin.
We're the LGBTQ Victim Advocate and Crisis Counselors at Victim Service Center.
Victim Service Center is a nonprofit in Orlando that helps victims of all crime, sexual assault, and we also work as the Rape Crisis Center for Central Florida.
We have free services that we serve clients for counseling, for group counseling and trainings, and we have specific services for the LGBTQ community.
If you want to find out more, go to our website at victimservicecenter.org or call our helpline, which is 24/7 at 407-500-HEAL.
Happy Pride!
Happy Pride! My name is Joseph Knoll. You may know me as Joey. I'm the founder of Spectrum Health. I started this organization because our community needed a better health experience.
Compassionate.
Acceptance.
Friendly.
Knowledgeable.
Safe.
Liberating.
Passionate.
You won't be sorry.
Convenient, affordable, LGBT-focused healthcare for everyone, everywhere, every time.
All the little drag babies that are now not drag babies, but they're not grown drag babies.
Are we going to do that again? Are we going to go back through all how old they are?
No, I forgot.
I don't even know their ages, really. Yeah. They're drag queens. They're timeless.
I've got a brain on 2020. I can't remember anything at this point in time.
Good point.
What I do want to do is just take some time and remember something that's very close to the Orlando community and to our hearts as we have been through 4 years of staying united and staying strong. And of course, recognizing our moment at the Pulse Memorial, which I just got chills.
I know, even thinking about it.
It was a really, really great day, and we got to spend the day out there taking time to remember. And I just want to remind you all that it's important for us to not forget that that is the moment that brought Orlando together. It made us stronger, it made us more unified, and in those moments where their chaos ensues, take some time and remember Pulse.
You know, it was so important to me that the day that we filmed, it was great to just be there for a little bit and just sit in the stillness and remember where we've come as a community and where we're headed.
Yeah, the interim memorial is truly beautiful. So take some time and go there. And then, of course, Barbara Poma is going to tell us about the future of all things Pulse. And of course, an amazing, amazing number with Tamisha Harris and Cesar De La Rosa. And I don't have a way to introduce it because it's just so beautiful that I'm pretty sure they should just take it away.
Yeah, so let's take you right now to Pulse Orlando.
I'm good.
In case people don't know who you are and where you are, let's go ahead and tell them all the information that they need to know about you and this beautiful place we are standing in.
Thank you, Blue. I am Barbara Poma, the owner of the Pulse Nightclub, the founder of One Pulse Foundation. And today we are standing at the Pulse Interim Memorial, which was built after the shooting, obviously, after the crime scene had been given back to us as owners. We wanted to make a more respectful, beautiful temporary space until the permanent memorial could be built. And so this was constructed by our community and our task force.
So as we're standing here years later, and you're moving forward with the new project, which also is going to take some time, how are you feeling about where we are in the community? Because afterwards we were so united and so strong. Do you feel like this is a clear representation of how Orlando reacted to Pulse?
Absolutely. I think even during the middle of COVID, you can see that Orlando is still as united. This community is so strong. I also think in the middle of all this social unrest that we are truly here peacefully making statements. I think that's a testament of our love of this community.
Speaking of COVID, we're doing a virtual Pride this year. So this is actually one of the first years ever, actually without afloat or walking, and so we want to make sure that Pulse is represented. And how are you feeling about that? I mean, it's kind of crazy, right?
It's a little crazy. It's also a little heartbreaking because, you know, Pulse was always a part of the parade. Since the tragedy, our families and survivors and first responders had joined us in that march. So for them, it was time to feel that love from their community, to be able to stand with their loved ones, walk for their loved ones, and for themselves. So I think that our stakeholders are really going to miss that this year.
Yeah. What would be your message to Orlando to keep them going on a day that we're actually not able to gather?
I think it's important for Orlando, the entire community, and the world who gets to watch us, that every year on June 12th, when we have our ceremony on site, that somehow, some way, whether rain or shine, a rainbow appears. And it is a sign from above. We all look forward to it. It's where Be the Rainbow came to be this year when we had our virtual ceremony, that we wanted people to be the rainbow when we couldn't be together. And that rainbow will shine bright on our Pride Day. I'm sure of it.
And so if we want to find out more about the One Pulse Foundation, where do we find that out?
It's really easy. Just go to our website, onepulsefoundation.org. You can learn all about our project and everything that we're doing in the community there all the time. The project we're working on here is creating a permanent national memorial at the site of the Pulse Nightclub. But down the street, we'll be building the Pulse Museum, which will encompass the history of Pulse, the history of the LGBT community, definitions of safe spaces, as well as encompassing the tragedy and the response from the world after. We will also have a third component, which is our Survivors Walk. Because Orlando Health is just so close in proximity, it was a journey that so many of our survivors took, whether it be by car, by foot, by being carried. It is just a place to honor their story. So all three projects will commence next year. The memorial will be finished by June of 2022. The Survivors Walk will be finished earlier, if not at the same time. And the museum will be finished in 2024.
Wow. Good luck with everything. Thank you for all you do. You're a hero.
Thank you. I love you.
Rise up this morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds sit by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you. I'm saying don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright, yeah. I'm saying don't worry about a thing, worry about nothing, oh, oh, it's gonna be alright. You with the sad eyes, don't be discouraged, though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all. The darkness inside you can make you feel so small. Extraño esa felicidad que he anhelado. Este mundo es inmenso y sé que puedes perder, pero llámame porque siempre estaré aquí. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, that's why I love you. So don't be afraid,
no,
to let them show your true colors. Your true colors
are beautiful,
like the
feeling. Look what we overcome. Oh, I'm gonna wave away. count all the reasons. We are the champions. There ain't no turning, turning back. Saying, oh, 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 can you taste the feeling? The feeling.
No one likes to be discriminated against, and no one should have to be discriminated against because of their sexual orientation or gender identity. Because of the things that we have gone through ourselves and our community, we know the importance of having that in our business and giving that back to our customers. Our customers seek us out because of that, for that confidence and that security.
Still have chills.
So good.
That was amazing. I just again want to say thank you to Tamisha and Caesar for an amazing performance. That was absolutely beautiful.
Absolutely. And thank you to the community for continuing to support all these years later. And it's also important that we take a moment to thank our sponsors that have really stepped up to make sure we could bring you Pride in the House this year. One in particular that we want to shout out is our presenting sponsor, 26 Health. We could not have done this without 26 Health.
26 Health is always there for the community, always giving back, and I just want to say, you guys are awesome. Wait, you all are awesome. Wait, every single one of you at 26 Health is awesome. Thank you.
Yes, absolutely. And you know who else is awesome?
Who?
We're in our headliner, so I get to introduce our first headliner, who we know is awesome.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah. And my twinning sis, because we look just alike.
I can't tell the difference between the two of
you. I sometimes look in the mirror and I'm like, whoa, look at me. I am you. And I'm, it's a dressing room joke. But a native of Orlando, Orlando Drag, and now in the world of drag because of that show.
She was on a little TV show. Some of you might have seen it. RuPaul's Drag Race, season 5. And All Stars 2, where she's known for making it clear.
That's right. You know, also a performer at Pulse. We just, we want to recognize that. You know, she was in Variety's one point in time, and I remember she wanted to do All I Want for Christmas.
Is you.
Is you. In a fur coat and some nude hose. She's going to be so mad at me for that, but it's amazing to see how far she's come. So.
Absolutely. So, everybody, now enjoy
Roxxxy Andrews.
not a plan. Guess I left my world in somebody's hands. I don't like to hurt much, but everyone gets weak. Someone to rely on, that's what I really need. Now here we stand, with all that we're worth. I've been through the pain and been dragged through the dirt. Whatever they tell you, we're bigger than words. I've been where you're standing, I know how it hurts. Let this be a song now, and this be a day. If we stand together, then we'll be okay. Cause we're survivors, we're making a way. Expecting the best when they hope for the worst.
For the last 30 years, Barefoot has walked stride for stride with the LGBTQ plus community.
Now for the first virtual Pride, we're continuing to march onward by celebrating the community's resiliency.
We all have our reason.
I march for diversity.
For love.
Continuing the fight.
Equality.
Support those who didn't make it this far.
For all of us to get back out there.
We all play our part.
However we come together,
march onward.
Hi, welcome to 26 Health, Central Florida's LGBTQ Health Center. I'm Dr. David Baker Hargrove, President and Co-CEO. At 26 Health, we strive to create an integrated, multidisciplinary health center that serves all of our community through primary medical care, behavioral health services, adoption services, patient care services, and our MediSpa. At 26 Health, we care for every letter. No matter how you identify, your letter matters to us.
One of my favorite songs, as we all know, Estelle's One Love, becoming synonymous with Orlando, and I have goosebumps again. You know, music is the answer, and that brings us to our next headline.
Yes, this is one of my favorites. You're going to know this song as soon as you hear it, because it's one of the ones that just, it makes everybody dance when you hear it on the dance floor.
This song never gets old.
Yeah.
It has moved through generations, and it never gets old. Like, you can see the babies singing this song. And I'm like, how do you know this song?
And the not-so-babies.
And then the not-so-babies.
That's us singing this song.
I'm excited.
I can't wait. So let's share her with you right now. Coming all the way from, I assume, her living room.
It was living
this
room.
This is Robin S. Thank you.
Happy Pride, my wonderful Wells Fargo family.
Pride celebration is super important to me because it reminds me of the fight for equality we're in, as well as it reminds me that I'm not alone.
Pride is not just about tolerance for people who may be different than you. It's about open, unconditional acceptance and inclusion.
Pride for me is first and foremost about freedom. Freedom from harassment, freedom from discrimination, freedom from societal expectations about who to love and how to be.
Pride is a particularly special time of the year where we as a community can take a step back, observe, and reflect.
My mind automatically goes to the history of Pride. Marsha P. Johnson throwing the first brick as a transgender black drag queen in the Stonewall riots. We're all part of one race, the human race. So with that, think about how you can connect with others.
I really encourage people to be open and listen to people's stories. If people could just be a little bit more open and say, I may not agree, but I think it's important that I listen, hear your story, understand that different point of view, understand that perspective, I think we would naturally become more inclusive.
I've taken time to learn about the people that came before me who went through insurmountable challenges in the fight for equality.
I think it's very powerful for a company to stand firm in the belief that all of our communities are deserving, are valuable, are valued.
This Pride Month, not only should we sing at the rooftops of how proud we are, but also fight the good fight for the ones that haven't found their voice.
To celebrate the progress and advocate the issues of the LGBTQIA+ community.
It's important to me because it stands for justice, equality, and love.
To spread awareness around the world about the LGBT community.
Because it brings attention to our community and it helps promote equality.
Because it gives voice and representation to a group that didn't always have it.
Because it creates a sense of community.
Celebrating Pride during COVID-19 times to me means more digital engagement. It's the way that we could stay close even though we're apart.
For me as an ally, Pride is a time where I need to step back and listen and learn while supporting this amazing community celebration of love and triumph.
To really stand in solidarity, not just with the LGBTQ community, but across all marginalized communities.
Let's recommit to a lesson of shared humanity, of pride in who we are individually and as friends and allies. And let's commit to a new sense of appreciation for all that we have and those that we love and those that we care for.
Oh, can you see my microphone?
Wait, no. Yeah, but this is...
I love that song so much. I mean, that's a classic dance floor hit. And thank you, Robin S., for being here with us in Orlando. That was awesome.
Wasn't that exciting to have Robin S. join us for all of this?
From her living room.
From her living room with those twinkly lights behind her.
Yeah, in your house.
Yeah.
I mean...
Pride in the house.
So that brings us to our final headliner.
Oh, so excited. This was honestly when we first started talking about creating Pride in the House, both of us at the same time said we gotta have her.
Of course, because an Orlando native, growing up in Orlando, starting her drag career here in Orlando, moving on to becoming a big star because of that TV show again.
Again, from season 5 of RuPaul's Drag Race and All-Stars 2 on RuPaul's Drag Race.
I love that so much. I mean, Orlando does have some of the best drag talent in the country. So we're really excited to bring this international celebrity back home.
You can't say it with a mocking tone. She really is an international. I know we've known her forever, but she's the world knows her.
That's just crazy.
It's crazy because she's crazy.
Well, that's true. And the name says it itself. So
it's true.
Bringing her back to her home turf at the Lake Eola Band Shell. And of course, giving you a little bit of Southern Nights Orlando too. It is our headliner for Pride in the House.
Detox! Thank you.
Hello and happy Pride, everyone. For 25 years, Watermark has documented the history of our local community, telling your stories and featuring the LGBTQ individuals that are making a difference in Central Florida and Tampa Bay.
Watermark publishes a bi-weekly newspaper with local, state, national, and world news, as well as arts and entertainment features. We also dive in depth into stories that matter to you. You can find the same type of news sections in Watermark that you see in your daily newspaper, but our focus is on the issues as they relate to the LGBTQ community and its allies.
Watermark is a free publication and is available at over 600 locations along the I-4 corridor, as well as St. Pete and Sarasota. You can find these locations at watermarkonline.com.
In addition to the newspaper, Watermark maintains a website updated daily, a weekly e-newsletter, and multiple specialty publications, some of which include a wedding guide, arts guide, and the official Come Out With Pride guide.
Watermark has been a sponsor of Come Out With Pride since its inception, and are grateful and proud to be part of this community since 1994.
Thank you to our readers for trusting us to tell your stories.
Thank you to our advertisers who have made our vision possible. Although we cannot be together in person right now, we are together in Pride.
We hope you have a happy and joyous Pride.
Baby detox. No, international celebrity detox.
International celebrity detox. Thank you so much for coming home to Pride in the House. We love you so much.
And thank all of you for joining us for Pride in the House. You know, we couldn't have done this without people to watch it. There's no point in creating art if nobody's there to watch the art, right?
That's very, very true. I'm telling you what. And thank you to Come Out With Pride. And I want to say thank you to you, Rob. First year on the board. You've done such a great job putting all this together. He's worked really hard to make this a special day for all of you in your house.
And I couldn't have done it without my partner, Blue Star, in your house.
In your house.
Well, in the house.
Yes, and of course we want to thank 26 Health for making this happen.
Absolutely. We couldn't have done it without our presenting sponsor.
And presenting sponsor.
All of our sponsors. And you heard so many great speaking points from local officials. There's no city in the world I can think of that's more supportive than Orlando. There's nowhere else I would want to be.
Because Orlando rocks.
It's true. And I hope that next year we can be with you in person. There's nothing I want more than for us to be back at Come Out With Pride at Lake Eola and seeing all your beautiful faces in person.
Yes, until then, stay safe, wear your masks, wash your hands, practice safe six.
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 It's, did you say safe six?
Good night, Orlando.
Good night. Bye from Pride in the House.
In the house.
In the house.
We're not in your house anymore.
No, we're leaving.
Yeah.
Happy Pride, Orlando! If all of the kings had their queens on the throne, we would pop champagne and raise a toast. To all of the queens who are fighting alone, baby, you're not dancing on your own. Can live without me, you wanna, but you get my mama. Think it's funny, but honey, can't run the show on your own. I can feel my body shake, there's only so much I can take. I'll show you how a real queen behaves. Oh, no damsel in distress, don't need to save me. Once I stop breathing fire, you can't tame me. And you might think I'm weak without a sword, but if I had one, it'd be bigger than yours. If all the kings had their queens on.
giving my love and getting.